Happy Tuesday, it's Shannon Wilkie with the Shine Advocacy Group, and I'm talking about executive functions again. I just want everybody to know about executive functions because so much growth can happen if tackled, the systems are put into place. So, executive skills are life management skills in a nutshell. They're fundamental, front of the brain based skills, and they're required for our students and ourselves to execute and solve problems. So especially students with ADHD or autism or other learning disabilities, they need more support in these areas to help, demonstrate their intelligence. Their intelligence needs to have supports to be demonstrated. So let that sink in. If your team is telling you that your student does not need any help because social, emotional, behaviorally, they might be struggling, but they are still very intelligent. Maybe their evals came back that they're even gifted. They can still have help at school, because they might have difficulty with the executive functions of organization, planning. You know, if you don't know how to plan and create a roadmap to have a task, it's not gonna happen. So let's take, okay, so for example, I'm working on course creation. I have been for a while. I'm creating some courses to help parents with executive functions and advocacy. If I wasn't able to use the executive function of planning, I couldn't have created a roadmap, used my whiteboard over there, and set a path to get that goal and task completed. And so if a student gets like the deer in headlights because they don't know how to plan out a task, we need to teach them. Think of it as working from the end backwards. So I actually used this with my son earlier. He had an assignment and it was daunting to him. A lot of times when kids have assignments that have the instructions online, so now, especially if the student's online learning or with technology, their school uses an iPad, it's really hard for them to see the instructions online and then to go back and create a Word doc or a written paper with those instructions in mind. So the first step is to make a framework with your child, whether it's a homework assignment or a project they're working on, even cleaning the room. So write down the parameters or the plan for the assignment. That's kind of like organizing it. And then take it and break it down. So for example, if the paper has to have four sentences, write four sentences. If the paper has to have, you know, a conclusion, two opinion sentences, things like that. Put it all together, and then the student can fill in that, it's called a graphic organizer, or that map, that plan of how they're gonna write. So writing is difficult when kids have executive function deficits. You can accommodate it by adding accommodations to their 504 or IEP. And accommodations can also tackle organization. Organization is just maintaining a system to keep track of our lives. I have like two planners and a phone with a calendar on it, and they all sync together to my work system that I use. And so kids, they get in class, they hit seventh grade, they have 5, 6, 7, 9 classes with no system. No student's going to do well with that. They need a system in place. Use a paper planner, use an online planner, get some type of system, and then a system to check in with them until they get that skill mastered and in place. So those are two of the big executive functions that our team of executive function coaches can help tackle. We have two of them, Sarah and Amy. They're both master's level teaching backgrounds, and they are fantastic. They can sit one-on-one with your student and help them with real life executive function. So they learn the process and they also get something done. So for example, they have to study for a driver's license exam. Let's make a plan on how we're going to do that. And then the coaches will help you through it. Their accountability, they check in and they coach right through the executive functions, teaching your student and yourself what they are and how to help. So time management would be the third. I would say, you know, time management, task initiation, organization, and planning are the main areas that they usually help students with. And they can work with students from grade school on up. We have college age students because those syllabuses are huge. And sometimes we need a little bit help breaking it down, getting our thoughts organized and getting a plan in place. All right, I hope that helps, and reach out to us at shineadvocacy.com under contact us if you'd like to have a consult about our executive function. Thank you.